2 years after he allegedly crashed his Bentley into another car, killing a man, polo magnate John Goodman's trial has started. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Paul Legrand.
And I'm Felicia Rodriguez. Our Kathleen O'Toole was inside the courtroom as the first witnesses took the stand. You can see right now live pictures inside the courtroom. They just broke for lunch. You're looking at John Goodman there as he's exiting the courtroom with his attorneys. Our Kathleen O'Toole joins us live from outside the courthouse with what happened today. Kathleen?
Well, Felicia, if you will recall, there were 3 days of tedious jury selection. In quite contrast to what's going on today, we had opening statements from both the prosecution, the defense, and now already cruising into the second witness. With a look that echoes the gravity of what's at stake here, John Goodman prepares for his first day of his DUI manslaughter trial, and the prosecution gets right to work.
And he said, "Give me 10 of your best shots of tequila."
Ellen Roberts, chief of the traffic homicide unit, paints the tale of what the prosecution says led up to Goodman's 0.177 blood alcohol level, and then what happened when he got behind the wheel.
There's a stop sign there at Lake Worth Road and 120th. Mr. Goodman blows that stop sign and slams his Bentley into the side of a Hyundai and literally pushes the little Hyundai into the canal.
While the prosecution repeatedly referred to Scott Wilson's car as little, defense attorney Roy Black wanted the jurors to think of Goodman's Bentley convertible as malfunctioning.
John Goodman is in the car. As it gets close to the stop sign, all of a sudden the car surges forward. You see him trying to control this enormously powerful car.
Roy Black went on to make a couple of other points. He said that John Goodman had no idea that Scott Wilson's car was upside down in the canal, giving the lay of the land, the topography of how the canal was 6 feet lower and the car was barely visible even to anyone during the daylight. He also talked about how John Goodman was seriously hurt with a broken wrist, a broken sternum, a concussion, and a bad back made worse by this accident, and that he went and got alcohol at a nearby barn after the crash. So you can see the defense shaping up there. The first witness to take the stand was a fellow by the name of Chris Campson. He is a polo player who knew John Goodman well. He is the man who had the barn nearby the crash with a bar inside of it fully stocked, tequila, bourbon, vodka, he testified to. The next woman who took the stand was the bartender who had served Goodman and a group of people drinks earlier in the evening. We've broken for lunch, and this will start again this afternoon. We'll be here on top of it for you. Live in downtown West Palm Beach, I'm Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25 News.